No, this is not a vape. It's the earbud cleaning pen from Hagibis, and today we'll be putting this tool to the test, matching it up against some of the dirtiest earbuds in my collection, and seeing how good it is at cleaning them, and some other things as well. Thanks to Hagibis for supplying me with one of these. Let's get started. The company clearly advertises this suspiciously vape-shaped tool as the perfect companion for your earbuds, but I'll be testing these to see how good they are at cleaning other things as well. The packaging of these is very simple, just paper and plastic. There's a little QR code here so you could verify the authenticity of a brush, and nothing else too special. I like this minimal packaging, to be honest. The design is very simple. It splits two parts and the brand name is on both sides. Pop it open to see the flocking sponge. It feels velvety and soft, but not very pleasant on the skin. I don't really want to touch this for long. And pop open the other side to reveal a cleaning brush and a sharp pen-like tool. We'll see if this ever comes in handy. And that's it. I don't know why I expected to see more, but here are the three tools. And one thing to mention is that you do have the freedom to switch around the orientation, so you could choose which tool is there when you open it up, and you could keep the case separately from the tools. But so far, it is a bit underwhelming in terms of functionality, so let's see how well this thing can do what it's made to do, cleaning. So one of the main advertising points for this tool is that it has a softer brush. One that won't scratch up your earbuds like other brushes, because somehow there seem to be counterfeits of a brush. So we'll test out how abrasive the brush really is using this pristine plastic surface. First up is the Q-tip. We're gonna rub this corner thoroughly with the Q-tip, just like we were cleaning it, as if we're removing some really bad earwax from it. And second up is a microfiber cleaning cloth, the kind that they give you when you buy a pair of glasses. We'll wipe this top with it. And third up is a Kleenex. This part. And fourth, we'll share between this sponge tip and the brush on the side. Now let's check the results. It's not terribly visible, but when you shine the light just right, you can see that the brush has indeed left some markings on the surface, especially the parts where I scrubbed it up and down as well as left and right. Not very visible here, but the paper tissue actually left quite a few markings as well. This amount of scratches shouldn't be very visible on a rounded or small surface, but I do recommend not using the bristles on a shiny, flat surface. Now here's where things are gonna get fun. I hand selected several of the dirtiest and most variously shaped earbuds from my little collection, and I've picked several earbuds from cleanish to bacteria breeding ground level. I'll be cleaning one side using each method and see which method is quicker and more effective than the other. Up on the left we have a wet wipe, tissue, Q-tip, and a toothpick. And on the other side, we have our cleaning tool and a tissue, because the dirty earwax needs to go somewhere instead of, you know, staying on the brush. The first contestant is the Lenovo XG01, one of my daily drivers for casual use. I have dry earwax and these will just require a light dusting off. The video you're seeing right now is sped up to 150% of the original speed. I got started on the inside a bit late for the left side, but you can see that the flocking sponge is just the right size for wiping the internal holes, while the smaller Q-tip takes a lot more time and effort to wipe out the entire inside. We then move on to the ear tip, and while the Q-tip was just the right size for wiping the hole in the ear tip, the flocking sponge was too big for the task. I had to resort to using the pen tip, which still managed to do the job, but was a bit more difficult to use. All in all, the Q-tip and tissue combo took a whole 10 seconds more than the cleaning pen did. Not so bad, I would call this round a tie for now. Second up is the Blitzwolf ANC3. I love these, I use them as my main pair, and I intentionally didn't clean these for over a full week. Now, this session was sped up at 2x the original speed because it took quite a bit longer. If you look at the right side here, the flocking sponge was big and thick enough to wipe the inside very quickly, while it took much more time wiping the other side with the wet wipe and the Q-tip since it required a lot more extra work to clean the same amount of space. Getting rid of dust from a matte surface wasn't that easy using the more traditional methods. Now, do take a close look at what's happening on the left. The right ear tip was quite easily cleaned with the sharp pen bit, but the left ear tip had to be cleaned with the Q-tip. And while I was trying to pull the Q-tip out the other side, the cotton swab fell off. The ear tips on the ANC3 are quite oddly sized, and Hagibis pen actually handled it perfectly. So, 1 point for Hagibis. Third is a pair of AirPods 2 with wet earwax. Although the actual amount of earwax is lesser, this will be a bit more challenging than the other earbuds since there are no rubber ear tips that you could just take off to clean. So I'm going to start off by giving everything a good wipe down with the tissue and wet wipe. And you'll see right here that the flocking sponge is just the right size to clean the barrel of the AirPods 2, while the Q-tip is too small and requires quite a bit of stirring around to be able to clean the inside of the case properly just like before. I'm actually going to skip over this part right here because the part I want to show is actually when I start getting the earwax off the AirPods speaker grills. If you look right here, you'll see that for the left I'm using the Q-tip and a toothpick, while for the right I just used the brush alone. And you probably wouldn't see it here, but the brush was getting rid of so much built up earwax that I had to keep on wiping the earwax off every couple of seconds. The Q-tip on the other hand was not effective at getting the earwax out of the little mesh and the cracks. I just had to end the Q-tip cleaning quickly because I just couldn't get the earwax out of the mesh grill, while for the brush on the right, the earwax just kept on coming out. I would say that the left ear tip ended up only halfway cleaned, while the cleaning pen was able to completely clean the earbud and the case. So despite taking a bit longer to finish, the cleaning pen definitely wins this round. And now, the final sample, the ancient bacteria breeding grounds. I got this one from a relative that I lent it to who unfortunately has wet earwax, and a lot of it. Now do notice that I needed an extra Q-tip for the left after last one just broke. And as you see right now, I'm trying to get rid of the grime in the cracks of the case, but to be perfectly honest, neither of the methods worked very well in removing it. The brush did show some progress, but most of the black grime was just too stubborn to scrub off. And you can again see the pattern of the sponge tip being much quicker at wiping the insides, while the smaller Q-tip needs a lot more movement to cover the same amount of space. I could use a tissue for some parts, but the barrel-shaped holes for the earpod stem are just a lot more difficult to clean without the cleaning pen. Now, the brush again worked wonders on the speaker grill itself, getting rid of quite a bit of the earwax out of the little holes. This ear tip, at least, was just the right size for the Q-tip on the left to pass through, and the Q-tip does work pretty well, you know, when it works. There was a lot of earwax and grime on the ear tips though, so it did need a thorough cleaning on both sides. To be honest, for something this dirty, you would need a good alcohol wipe to go along these methods to ensure a proper cleaning. But this is just a casual cleaning and not, you know, a full-on disinfection. And the cleaning pen took around 8 seconds more than the other method, which is still pretty impressive. So this thing really does work, and I was particularly surprised at how much stuff it was able to remove from the mesh grill of a pair of earphones. I did try this out on a smartphone speaker grill and it didn't work out that well, so I would say that it is optimized for usage on earbuds rather than other products. But I do believe that this is one product that I will be using quite regularly from now on. And just a little FYI before I end the video, I will be going to college soon and I'm not sure how that would affect my schedule. Maybe it would give me more time to work on my video production, and maybe it won't. But in any case, I will be back in the next video with another product to review. And until then, hope you guys stay safe. And please do watch some of my other videos if you guys like this one too. Thank you all. I'll see you in the next one.